Somalia or Somaliland is considered as a fragile state, which is characterized by, let's say, an existing government, but this government is working with quite a lot of deficiencies, low budget, and one challenge of the SNRD is taking this country as an example, is that we are working more and more in fragile circumstances. That means also from GIZ side that the staff who's usually supposed to work in the countries isn't coming from outside. They have no background from GIZ. When I started, I was the only GIZ staff member there. And the topics and the level you are working on is extremely low. So for SNRD, it's really important to consider not only to look at this, let's say, high-tech solutions like we do it in more advanced countries like Kenya, Ghana, Senegal, South Africa, but also to consider more and more those fragile countries where we really have to go two steps back and to start from scratch or almost from scratch.
So how do you operate in a country like that?
You are not an NGO, you're an NGO. On the other hand, you have to work a bit like an NGO. That means you have to try to integrate in your daily approaches on micro and macro level, on micro and meso level, the government staff, but the government staff almost does not exist. Yeah. So we have, for instance, a system without extension worker. And in addition, in Somaliland, it's not a habit. There are no motorcycles, there are no motorbikes, there are no bicycles as such. So means of transport do not exist. So you have to go for other approaches, how you get the message in the villages.
What do you do to overcome this?
With our own staff whom we qualify, we work with a TOT system in the villages. That means we look for focal persons in the villages whom we can qualify on a moderate level in agriculture as well as in livestock production in order to create resources in the country and in the village and also to create on a very, very low scale income generation for this person, because there must be an incentive why you go and why you work as an extensionist. So that means they take over in a certain extent the task of the government.
Looking at what's going on the internet, one gets the impression that there's quite a active diaspora out there, Somali diaspora. What role do they play?
The diaspora is looking and they want to return, or they want at least to invest in business related to agriculture. So that means there's where the linkage can come in once you have a value chain which is at least promising no depth and which is at low risk.
What does it mean for the cooperation that there is more and more fragile states?
You cannot achieve fast large numbers if you want to work at least a bit sustainable. Yeah. So you really have to build up basic structures and then you can think about scaling up to a certain extent, and this takes time. And me working in a livestock sector, for instance, we have a project which was 3 years duration. It's impossible. Yeah. So that means you have to look for intervention areas where you can have quick and immediate visible results, but you do not have a chance really to work on medium and long-term development